described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Film Ideas Inc. presents the World Heritage, Mont-Saint-Michel in Hawaii.
Throughout Europe, there are dozens of places bearing the name Mont-Saint-Michel. Many are linked to old miracle tales describing how Michael the Archangel descended from heaven to a hilltop in a saintly visitation. Of all these sites, Mont-Saint-Michel stands out as the best known, the most enduring, and the most spectacular. For over 800 years, this island has accumulated a variety of structures, each built in an architectural style reflective of the period. Regarded as the most beautiful monastery in France, Mont-Saint-Michel and its bay were designated a World Heritage Site in 1979.
It's surrounded by a tide pool and a strip of land. Western Europe is shown on the globe.
In the southern part of Normandy, there is a stretch of shallow waters along the coastline near the base of the Cotentin Peninsula.
In the northwest,
on an islet among the sandbanks between Normandy and Brittany, stands a Benedictine abbey dedicated to Saint Michael the Archangel. Small granite hills that have withstood the battering force of the sea dot the sandy beaches. Mont-Saint-Michel stands on one of these rocky crests about 5 kilometers or just over 3 miles offshore. When the tide is high, the island appears to float as if magically suspended.
The abbey is viewed from below, showing spires and sky above stone walls.
Mont-Saint-Michel, or Mount St. Michael in English, is an historic Christian monastery founded 1,300 years ago.
A gold angel tops a spire.
Since then, the site has been repeatedly enlarged through different phases of construction. In 708 AD, St. Aubert was bishop of this province. Legend has it that Aubert dreamed that Archangel Michael appeared before him and directed a church be built in this area. So the bishop had a small chapel built on a rocky hill surrounded by forests. It is said that once the chapel was completed, the forests were inundated by a violent tidal wave and transformed overnight into the bay that exists today. Eventually, in the 10th century, the church became a Benedictine monastery. Because of this connection to St. Michael, a steady flow of pilgrims would make their way to Mont-Saint-Michel for the next 1,000 years.
Two buses pass a parking lot.
Today, it is possible to visit Mont-Saint-Michel by car or bus. A road winds along the top of the pier to a parking lot directly in front of the entrance to the island.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.